Hello, I am Jan from Prague, the Czech Republic, and in this video I want to show you why I am fascinated by high dynamic range photos on mobile phones. I mean, the ability to take photos, but above all, to share what was previously impossible to capture: glowing skies, shining sun, bright colors. I took the Xiaomi 15 Ultra to several Balkan countries, and with the help of 200 photos from mountains to cities, I will show you how it all works and why it is extremely interesting to experiment with HDR videos like this one. What you'll see in this video. First, I will explain the main challenges of HDR photos and summarize why I consider HDR videos, such as the one you are watching right now, to be a major technological breakthrough. I will quickly explain how I created this video, and then we'll look at about 200 photos from several fascinating places in Balkan countries. And please note, this video should be watched on a device that can display HDR, such as high-end mobile phone or television. As I have already mentioned, this video was made with Xiaomi 15 Ultra. I won't be covering details, specifications and all that stuff because I have recorded very detailed review. So please do watch it and you'll find all the basic information there. HDR means high dynamic range, meaning the ability of your camera or mobile phone to capture huge differences between shadows and light and all these very complex situations. Now you might be asking, well, what's so special on it? And yes, that's a good point, because mobile phones can do it on its own. So these shots are typically the shots you are able to do and see in your mobile phone. Also, you are able to export them with all these glowing skies and amazing colors to, say, Instagram. If you just go to Instagram, you'll see a lot of photos are just really shining and glowing. So yes, Instagram supports HDR, but that's more or less the end, because if you share the photos, if you edit a simple video with that on your mobile, a lot of the glow effect will be just gone. It won't be HDR anymore. And this is one of the tools you are able to play. This is Lightroom. This is the first version where you can see the histogram, and it's simply limited. Once you activate HDR, you suddenly have all of that space you are able to work with. Then, to be very specific and concrete, you do not have, as I already mentioned, to turn on anything. On Xiaomi 15 Ultra, you are able to turn it on, turn it off here with this button. Please do keep it activated. There is no reason why you should turn it off. What you have to do, though, is that if you want to have the HDR videos, you have to activate it with this button. And you can check it if you download the video. Your computer will show you that little badge here, which says HDR. And by now you're probably asking, what's the point of this video? Why should I be doing that? And the point is here, and it's probably the most important message I have for you. If you have hundreds and thousands of your family and travel photos, you are able to edit them and share them in HDR. And share them, for instance, with the YouTube, as I am doing right now with you. What you have to do, and this is really a catch, because you can't do it at the moment at your mobile phone. You have to use some special editing software. I'm using Final Cut Pro, and in that software, you have to activate editing in HDR. That's one condition. Unfortunately, it's not possible just to take the photos and place them into the video. You have to do one important step. You have to open Lightroom. That's the best choice you have. And you have to export the photos in a format which would support HDR. The best would be TIFF, as you can see here, or AVIF. Point is, if you want to edit HDR photos into your HDR video, you have to, at the moment, export it separately. It's not just enough to import the photos into your software. Let's see some examples. And once again, why should we be playing with this? And this is not abroad, this is in my native Czech Republic. Amazing sun is rising and over this lake. And yes, this is a very typical case where you would just love to have HDR at your disposal. Because yes, I mean, if you take that shot without HDR, if you print this shot, if you share this shot into non-HDR world, you'll be just disappointed. Of course, a huge part of the photos you'll see in a couple of next minutes have sun in it or have some very complicated light. Yes, but again, that's the point. We were not able to share photos like that only a couple of years ago. Now we have that amazing power to play with these photos and really push all the photography to new levels. One more example, really lot of colors, flowers, interesting old house, and now you have the chance to show it in HDR, which will bring completely new fresh look to your photos. Again, sun, colors, flowers, and so on. And now we jumped to Lake Ohrid, which is in northern Macedonia. And this is really important example because typically if you would be here in these mountain passes, the sun is shining, you know, and typically if you wouldn't be using HDR display, that would just be extremely boring. The sky would be dull, the colors would be washed out, the shadows would just probably be totally dark. So again, I am really trying to show you that once you enter the world of HDR, even if you embrace what I'm trying to show you now, it means converting the shots into something which can be shared with video, maybe with some music or your commentary, you're opening completely new dimensions, completely new world. And some more examples. This is probably one of the most famous photos or places in this country. It's again, Ohrid Lake, fascinating place, and some roses and some shadows, a very complex, very complicated light. And I'm really apologize that I'm really going that quickly. Sometimes, you know, you are critical and you're writing to me, well, you should not be that quick, but I just want you to have the feeling what we are able to achieve first with, yes, the Xiaomi 15 Ultra. And you don't really have to have the Xiaomi 15 Ultra. You can achieve this with pretty much any mobile phone you have in your hands. And again, the catch is, the charm is that if you were here with a traditional camera, you'd really have to shoot into RAW, then you would have to edit it. And wow, mobile phones are able to do this on their own. One important question is, why is it so complicated? Why shouldn't it be easier? And I'm sure it's coming. I'm sure this is so important, so amazing technology that I just can't see that within 1 or 2 years you would not be able to do the same in your mobile or with some semi-automatic applications. So please take this video as well, quite important introduction, as a information that yes, this can be done, a new wave of very interesting videos with photos, videos shot and uploaded to YouTube in HDR quality is here, and it will change a lot. Because I would typically be telling people, do not shoot sunset, it's so boring. But here's the evidence. I did shoot my first sunset in 5 years, but knowing that I'll be using this in HDR, knowing that I'll be exporting this for you in HDR YouTube video, well, I simply realized that might work. And it does indeed work, because you are able to get a lot of, you know, nuances into shot. It does make sense. Some more photos from this amazing place. These are rather boring, very normal. But again, if you are there and you would be using traditional technology or traditional camera, you would be struggling with the shadows. You'll probably won't be able to have all these clouds, all these shining colors. So really interesting examples. And of course, I'm speaking mostly about HDR, but of course, you can take this also as a second part of my review of Xiaomi 15 Ultra, which I consider to be really interesting camera. I can show you also some video recordings from that place. And again, you see it is really worth experimenting with this. Some more photos, some more colors. And as I say, really, once you start playing with that, you won't be able to stop. I mentioned I do not want to go into technical details of that specific mobile phone, but I have to do one exception. I really love a 70mm lens, which is capable of shooting fantastic shots like that. For me, this is one of the most amazing lenses I have ever seen in any mobile phone. And this is Skopje, the capital city of Northern Macedonia. And well, as you can see, it was really, really extremely hot. And I was really able to take shots only at night. But it was worth doing that because if you were here and you would be doing the same, you just won't be able to get these lamps to glow so much. So even during night shooting, and you'll see some more examples in a couple of minutes, this is really quite important. Let's go to the mountains, let's see some more examples, churches, temples, details, flowers. Yes, of course, not all of these photos are shot with really important part of HDR. But still, the fact that you are able to shoot in shadows, make photos like that, is extremely important. What I did not mention is that all these shots are unedited. I didn't touch them. And yes, of course, if I, for instance, work with these photos, I would be able to make them even much more interesting. I would be even able to push the HDR effect to new dimensions. Glowing colors, some more details of cafes, an interesting car full of flowers. And in this cafe, well, this is a boring shot, yes. But if you are a photographer, you know that it's quite hard to capture things like this because the cab is in shadow, we have light coming out from the window. But still, thanks to HDR, thanks to huge dynamic range, we are able to make things which would normally be boring to be glowing and to be interesting. So do not forget to use it. We were not lucky in city of Prizren here. It's amazing city, but the light was really boring. But still, the camera, the mobile phone is able to do it because it's able to work with HDR. So the clouds are really interesting, really, really intriguing shot. One more example, city of Pristina in blue hour. You probably know that if you take shots about 20 minutes after the sunset, the sky can be amazingly blue like here. Well, the lights are really not dim, they are shining and the photos are really amazing. And yes, you are right, that would typically be the most interesting example of why you should be using HDR. Well, you know these shots, if you would be shooting in world without HDR, these shots would have no chance to survive because the shadows would be dark, the sky would be dull, it would be boring. But again, HDR is here and it is here to rescue us with night photography or photos like that. This is rather boring shot from amazing accommodation in the mountains, but if you are a photographer, you know that this is quite a tough task because you have a lot of shadows, you have bright sky, you have amazing colors in the slopes of the mountains, but still, thanks to high dynamic range, we are able to take a shot of it, and thanks to HDR technology, which YouTube is able to deliver, I am able to show you what I've seen from my window. And some final closing shots from amazing mountains and amazing colors of flowers and waterfall. And this is quite an interesting combination. You basically got a photo which you can't be getting normally. And finally, a couple of examples of video shot with Xiaomi 15 Ultra. Today, I concentrated mostly on photos because it's actually much more complex and much more complicated to use them and work with them, because in the case of video, you just record it and you are able to work with this, you are able to edit it. But please do not forget what I mentioned at the beginning of that video, that if you want to play with photos, you can't skip some really complicated tasks like exporting them. But in the case of video, well, you just download it and you are able to edit it, as you can see here. So, thank you so much for your attention. I hope I gave you some inspiration, and I do really wish you luck if you decide to enter the world of HDR. Take care. I am Jan from Prague, the Czech Republic.